50 years. Oh my gosh, Kimberly Ann, it seems like only yesterday. Your dad and I rushing off to the hospital, awaiting the arrival of our little person. I remember when the nurse brought you into me, my little girl, all wrapped up tight in a pink little blanket. She put you in my arms, and I saw the red hair and said, "Excuse me, I think you brought me the wrong kid." She laughed and assured me that you were the right one. So I went ahead and took a closer look. Sure enough, there was that Francis Coney nose, and I knew right away, you were ours. Little did I know that you were looking back at me, thinking, "Thanks for the nose, Mom. And could you please stop blinking? It's so annoying." We had fun together those first 4 years, you and I. Kiddie pool in the backyard, long bike rides, lots of beach time, had fun at the beach. You remember, Kim, all the things I did to make you sweat. Then off you went to school. You absolutely loved kindergarten. Loved kindergarten.
I actually met Kim in kindergarten, believe it or not. Horizon Elementary, Mrs. Bell's class. It was nap time. I remember I couldn't sleep, so I peeked one eye out, and across all those kids, I saw a little eye peeking back at me. It was Kim. I knew right then.
Couldn't stand him. Totally annoyed you. You know, kind of like today, Kim. Some things never change.
When did she say this?
Kim always wanted to be a pharmacist. I mean, she couldn't get hired at the local Walgreens because we were like 8 years old or something like that.
She was really into wanting to be a pharmacist.
She really wanted to sell drugs. I mean, like that was her passion. I remember when she started. Was little stuff at first, marijuana, then coke, angel dust.
She was selling coke and marijuana even before it was legal.
I had my own thing going on. Lucrative. Jolly Ranchers, Blow Pops, Now and Laters, you name it. I was selling it. Get it for 25 cents, sell them for a dollar. What a racket. I remember Kim's territory was getting larger. I mean, she had the whole area. Mr. Grocer, Mr. Grumps, Mario the Baker, Broward Mall, you name it. Kim's filthy tracks were everywhere. I'll never forget the time that Steve Sims was selling. I mean, he was only doing lemonade, but she wanted him gone. That was tough. But I had to do what I had to do. Kim didn't take no for an answer. Never forget the Marcus brothers, Lyle and Shale. They had their Rubik's Cube racket right in the corner. Kim didn't like that. She wanted me to run them out, so I did. Oh, I took care of it. Never saw those two again. Kim just inherently knew how to be ruthless. She was quite the kingpin. Well, queenpin, as we like to call her. Get chills down my spine thinking of some of those days. Well, I gotta go. I have a cake in the oven then. I gotta get it out.
So back in the 80s, as a student at Bear Middle School, one of my favorite classes was Miss Jacobson's yearbook class. I was lucky enough to be one of the yearbook editors, and one of my responsibilities each year was to send out a student survey. That survey was for the student superlatives, categories such as best dressed, best all around, most likely to succeed. Well, while we were in sixth, seventh, and eighth grade, and as the editor, I started to receive multiple write-ins for a certain category. And those write-in votes were so overwhelming that we had to make an additional category. And that category was entitled Sluttiest.
I volunteered to go into the category with her because the teachers thought it was just sexist if it was only a girl. My mom got upset, so I had to hand over the guy's side of the title. But Kim won all 3 years, sluttiest in sixth grade, sluttiest in seventh grade, and then most sluttiest in eighth grade.
I don't know if you remember, Jason Goodman used to throw these spin-the-bottle parties, and Kim was always the one you'd want to get with 7 minutes in heaven.
Sure, I remember Kim. When a pretty strawberry blonde girl asks you if you want to see her strawberry, trust me, that's something you don't forget. Turned out she wanted to show me her strawberry-shaped birthmark.
The fun part was she seemed so innocent. Right.
We all knew that she was going to wind up in the San Fernando Valley, the porn capital of the world.
I don't know where they got this. She was not slutty. Not around me.
Congratulations, Kim, on receiving the title as sluttiest girl all 3 years of middle school.
Kim who? Gargiulo? Gilberti? What Kim? There's so many Kims. Oh, Kim Rolfing. Right. Yeah, I remember Kim. Yeah, I remember her. Second grade, Horizon Elementary. Yeah, in fact, I think she's the one who taught me sign language so we could cheat. Yeah, nice, right? We cheat Miss Mafitano's class all the time. Sixth grader, she had like a wad of money, bankrolls of money. Never quite understood it, but it was all right because we'd go to Sunny's after school and she'd treat me some gum. So made up for it. But then things kind of turned, got a little dark. And I'm not sure if I can say this, but maybe with the statute of limitations and everything, it's all right. But what got me was the Grand Theft Auto.
Wait, what?
Yeah, she stole a car. Yeah, Miss Fishbein's car. Of all people, Miss Fishbein. I mean, she jumped the curb and almost ran the car into the window of Dance Fan City, but it's because she was too young to drive. I mean, somehow she talked me into switching seats and I took the rap for it, but it was all right. I only did 22 months.
You never told me this.
I've taught for about 40 years now, and my most memorable student, I'd have to say, is Kim Rolfing from back in Piper High School in Florida.
Absolutely. She made such a big impact on me, on both of us, I think.
She was really conscientious, always did her homework, asked questions, and I remember she would come up after class, come up to my desk to ask a question, and I'd be like, whoa, Kim, back up a little bit, you know, I'm married. And I remember I told my former wife about, you know, her, and my former wife didn't believe me.
Yeah. Well, I was married at the time also, and I'd left lesson plans at the house or something. And so my former husband was bringing them to school, which was very nice. But then later I heard that, he was seen leaving campus with Kim.
Wow. Two of us ended up bonding over our broken marriages.
Absolutely. Married over 28 years. I guess it's because of Kim. Kind of, maybe she did it on purpose. Being a matchmaker, I'm not sure. She could see things that just others couldn't.
And I really wish I could thank her.
Yeah.
And we started officially dating at the end of 11th grade. But she wouldn't let me tell anyone she was my girlfriend.
We first met Kim during her high school years when Garrett was tutoring her in mathematics. They would sit at the kitchen table for hours, we presume, doing math.
That's our perspective, and we're sticking to it.
It was during grad night, 1989, that Kim Rolfing, also known as Kim Number Two, I'm Kim Number One, she approached me that night about the idea of the Kim swap. She would ask me to do things like when she didn't want to do them. Then prom night came and Kim Number Two did not really like her date. Anyway, she wanted to do the Kim swap at the after party. Lucky me, I guess.
Yeah, the Kim swap thing was awesome. I mean, so the whole prom after party, staying at the guest quarter suites, I mean, I was excited, and then to hear about a Kim swap was super cool. I mean, not cool for Garrett, obviously, but cool for me. I mean, I learned a lot that night, to be sure. Had a little bit of a back problem the next day, but it was all good by me, so.
Kim swap? I didn't know anything about a Kim swap. Can we stop?
I remember Kim. We went to high school and college together. We actually worked at Walgreens together, too. I was a stock boy and she worked in the pharmacy. One time I made her mad, and then so she spiked my water with isoniazid, which made my pee orange. Yeah, really funny joke, haha, but I was worried for a whole week. Then after that, she was acting really bizarre, and she was coming on to me, and she was all over me, and I was uncomfortable with that because I knew my friend Garrett liked her and wanted to date her. I told her that, and then she got really mad. Afterwards, I caught her trying to kill me and poison my drink with amiodarone, which would stop my heart. Once that happened, I said, I gotta stay away from this lady. She's just crazy. A real sociopath.
So, Kim was my roommate in pharmacy school, and Kim is very smart, and she can study for a test for an hour and ace it. The way that she liked to study usually was in the bathtub. So she would get her notes and her books and everything and be like, I'm going in the bathroom. It was like a really long night and I was getting ready to go to bed and I was like, gosh, I hope she's okay in there. Like she's been studying for hours. So I was gonna tell her that I was going to bed and kind of tap on the door. But then when I went to go do it, I could hear her in there and there was a noise that the only way I can describe it is like a vibrating noise. So I just went to bed and I left her alone. So I guess, I don't know, maybe she was doing more than studying when she was in the bathroom. I mean, good God, I don't know. Maybe she'll tell us.
And then they were 3,000 miles apart, 3,000 miles without any public symbols of togetherness, and therefore many questions from our friends, your friends, and we never asked you guys anything.
I watched you grow and spread your wings. High school, college, residency, then off you went to California with that annoying little kid, Garrett, to start a whole new life so very, very far away.
So I plan this big, elaborate wedding proposal. I send a limo to pick her up at work.
Come in here for a minute.
Hi.
Hi, Kim.
Yes.
Oh, what a
cool little thing. Look who's there.
I'm calling sick.
What is this?
Oh, that red.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah, so, I mean, Gary asked me to take pictures of the engagement and, you know, I think he was basically too cheap to hire a photographer, so he asked me to do it.
Hello. I'm so excited.
It's a little awkward. Like, I don't know if... Are you sure you want me to talk about this? I mean, whatever. I'll just tell you what happened. I mean, we were, you know, basically in the limo, driving to meet Garrett. Although, you know, Kim didn't know, but that's where we were going. And, you know, Garrett had arranged this scavenger hunt.
Takes her to a flower shop. She gets a huge bouquet of roses, to a bakery to get a cake. Meanwhile, I'm waiting at a hot air balloon to whisk her off into the sunset. Just us, most romantic night of our lives.
In the limousine, I ask Kim, like, well, what do you think we're doing? Like, where do you think we're going? We could be doing anything. Like, we could be driving to Mexico and kidnapping you, for God's sake. Like, whatever. And you could probably find this on tape somewhere. I mean, we were recording the whole thing. So anyway, I said, Kim, you know, who do you think we're meeting? And she looked at me and was like,
it could be Fred.
You think
yeah.
It's Fred?
It could be Fred.
It was like, ooh, Fred. shit. You know, the look on Kim's face.
Oh, please no. Oh, no.
No, I've never seen these. Who's Fred?
She's such a nice person. I mean, she said yes. I'll marry you, and then, you know, they take off in this fakata hot air balloon and fly off. Anyway, not much of a romantic story, I guess.
Well, that's why she tried to jump out.
Kim was just a little reluctant at first, but Garrett was relentless in his
pursuit. And I gave up the idea of our son marrying a Jew. But a blonde-haired, blue-eyed German? Seriously? Her people killed our people.
They saw each other for about a year before Kim would admit to her friends, or indeed herself.
You know that part in a wedding when they ask if anyone objects? Well, I think Kim nixed that part from the wedding. I thought about objecting, but I was like 11, so.
I know.
Give this really nice
vote. All right.
We hope it doesn't.
Well, I've known Kimmy my whole life, but I'd have to say my fondest memory of Kim was probably at her wedding when I was about 9 years old. And there was a point of the wedding where it was the reception, and they threw the bouquet and the garter belt, and I luckily came up with the garter belt, this Florida Gator garter belt, and I was really excited. I went over to her table. And sat right next to her, and Garrett, my cousin, was right there too. And she said, you know, catching the garter belt is really good luck. You're going to get lucky tonight. And I was only 9, so I didn't really understand what she meant. But, about 30 minutes later, Kim and I's relationship got a lot closer. And I can say that was probably the best wedding that I ever been to. And, I really look forward to seeing her, after that a lot. She became my favorite cousin. The interesting thing, though, is since then, she's been calling me Little Andrew, and not really until now I've connected the dots. I hope that's not a slight at me.
You know, I haven't seen my wife naked yet.
Dating game contestant, Mark Sherman. With his beautiful,
Mark,
lovely
pick
date.
Me, pick me, Mark, pick me.
My cousin Kim, I grew up idolizing her. I even caught the bouquet at her wedding, which I thought was pretty magical at the time, and that Prince Charming would show up and swing me off my feet. And now, 22 years later, I'm pretty sure Kim is some kind of witch, and she put a reverse hex on that stupid bouquet. You know what? I'm done talking.
Great. Have I seen Kim as a mother? Have you seen the movie Mommy Dearest?
No wire hangers ever!
She also has a little bit of John Wooden mixed in. When I was born, my mom had to stop being a pharmacist and become a homemaker. I felt bad about it, so I made up this whole wheelchair thing. You know, just to give her something to do.
I received a call from my brother Kunti. His name's not really Kunti. We just give him that nickname Kunti because his name is Kenti. And so if you put Kunti and Kenti together, you get Kunti Kenti. But anyhow, that's besides the point. He called me in a very, very anxious way and was worried about Garrett, his son, who is my nephew, so naturally I was worried about it as well. But he was worried that Kim was going to influence him into a right-wing state and that she had some type of a fascist leaning because of her last name being Rolfing, which has German has a German attachment. So I decided the best thing to do was to invite Kim and Garrett and the kids over to view Agoura Hills and Oak Park where we live, and was able to convince them to move here so we could keep an eye on them, especially Kim. And we think we have a handle on it now, but we're still watching her very, very closely.
I was so excited when I knew that Garrett and Kim were moving to our hood and we could get together for weekly Sunday dinners. That was until I discovered Kim's love of Diet Coke. From then on, I must have spent thousands of dollars of money buying Diet Coke. It was either that or pretend that I didn't have any, or I had to hide what I did have, just like you do when an alcoholic cousin comes over.
I first met Kim in 2001 at Mommy and Me. The kids were about 6 months old, and there was a big group of moms, like maybe 20 new moms. First thing that happens right off the bat, Kim tells everybody she's having an extramarital affair.
Well, it wasn't technically an affair.
Well, whatever. It was a prison pen pal, but they were all love letters.
Like sexting before sexting existed?
Sure. So right around when the time when Zeke was going to turn one, the guy gets out on parole, and Kim really wanted to see him. So she invited him to Zeke's birthday party, told him to dress up like a clown so nobody would know.
Oh my gosh, is that who that was?
That's totally who that was. I knew right then she was a baller and we were going to be friends for life.
How did we meet Kim? Oh, I remember how we met Kim.
At Gymboree.
Yeah. Yeah, they met at Gymboree.
It was 20 years ago. And we had a little baby Bailey and a little baby Zeke. And across the room, Kim noticed that I was wearing the same locket.
Yes.
That she had.
It was a special locket.
Well, it was a special locket, but I didn't know that so many other people had.
Well, that's the thing. We don't see these lockets very often.
Yeah.
And did you approach her with it? She approached you with
it? No, she approached me.
Right. Yeah. And so, I mean, they both noticed. And obviously the locket is, you know, is the swingers locket, right? I mean, it just means we're open,
yeah,
you know, to other couples. So it would have been the birthday party.
Yeah, Bailey's first birthday party.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's...
May of 2001.
Yeah, that's right.
There was a bounce house.
Yes, well, I remember the bounce house. I mean, I'm sure Kim and Garrett remember the bounce after the kids were gone. You know, they were
nap time.
It was nap time. And you know, when the bounce house is a bouncing, don't come a trouncing. Yeah. I don't know. It was a good time. And and we realized pretty quickly that Kim and Garrett were gonna be excellent friends.
Hey Kim. We've known each other for a really long time. And you know how much I care about you, so I was really happy and honored at the request to become one of your partners. Of course, I was initially taken aback. I wasn't very familiar with all the nomenclature of the lifestyle that you and Garrett lead, but wasn't sure between the nuance if you guys were swingers or a polyamorous, open marriage or ethical, non-monogamous. I mean, whatever you guys classify as, certainly no judgment for me. I mean, I used to have sleepovers at Garrett's all the time when I was a little kid, so maybe this is just kind of a natural progression.
So it was really right after the birthday, I think, that I said to Sabrina, you know, Kim looked familiar.
Yeah.
And I couldn't place it. There was something really familiar about her. About a week later, I was going through my 90s VHS porn collection, which, you know, we like to delve into every so. It's mostly me, but you know, I was just kind of, you know, just fast forwarding through. And that's when I realized, I saw her. I knew her from porn, from all the porn she had done. But of course, back then she went by the name Kimberly Mumolo. I'd spent a lot of time with Kim before I spent time with Kim. I mean, that's the only way I can say it. Yeah, it was just, you know, she was pretty impressive. You know, she was a good little actress, and it was just a good time. So Kimberly Mumula.
Digging a stone and going down excavation. I and I, the sun is feeling I can fly so hard. Elevation!
My mom was always very focused on glamour. She spent half her life on red carpets and in limos. So when she wanted her daughter to learn proper glamour techniques, she started drilling me from a very young age. Photo shoots all day. She demanded I learn to explore and dominate my femininity. Honestly, it was just exhausting. And I think I was really young for that.
Mwah. Did you get it?
Yep. Yeah. Awesome.
Is she gone?
She went upstairs.
Okay, this is a good time then. You guys need to help us. Lily's going crazy, and it's all Kim's fault.
Wait, are you guys talking about her chymoclositis?
No, it's crazy. Like yesterday, she put away my glass while it was still in my hand.
I can feel her watching me in my sleep.
Yeah, one time I saw her pouring Diet Coke into your mouth.
How are you just telling me this now? What?
Please, Kim, like seriously, you're the only one that can stop her. It's like,
I can't keep watching Hallmark Mysteries. It's hypnotizing me.
Hey, did you guys open one of my A2 packages from QVC?
No. Getting a craving.
What's happening to me?
Hi, can I get 8 large Diet Cokes?
One of the things that we were really surprised to learn about was Kim's gambling problem. We were out in Vegas on one of our family trips. On the second night that we were there, we were all out. We were going to go see a show, and we saw the show. And later, we happened upon Kim in the casino. She was over at one of the blackjack tables. From what we could tell, in the 30 minutes that we were standing there watching, she must have dropped, I think it was around 10,000.
I think so.
There was a small crowd. Clearly, she didn't notice that we were there. But when she finally did see us, she took us aside. She begged us not to say anything. That made us super uncomfortable. She could sense our hesitation. And that's when she propositioned Dion.
Yeah, it was like the movie Indecent Proposal. She really did look good. And, had he not been there.
Really?
No.
Really?
No, obviously no. She was visibly upset and went off to, I guess, try to win some of her money back. I guess. About an hour later, we caught up with her at the bar, and that's when she told us she'd lost another 40 grand.
And that was about 20 minutes after that I got the call from the bank asking me if I'd withdrawn another $20,000 from our savings account within the casino.
She stole my purse. That bitch stole my motherfucking purse.
So I was just a minor at the time, and I was in the arcade room when Kim stumbled in, hair kind of messed up, shirt untucked, the whole ordeal. So I just figured she was with Garrett, but the cologne on her did not smell like his, but not my business. And she had mentioned something about needing to make up some ground and needing a little bit extra money. So she proceeded to ask me how many quarters I had in my cup. And I was just like, I'm just trying to win a stuffed animal. Ask my parents. I don't know.
It's a story we talk about to this day. Degenerate.
We've known Kim for about 15 or 18 years, I think. And she seems like she's okay. She's a nice girl.
Kind of quiet.
What's
not
a little
very
bit
funny.
Weird is we go on our walks every night to take our dogs. And she comes, she doesn't even have a dog. It's a little weird.
Can you help us understand why it is a young woman like you would want to walk with neighbors with dogs when you don't have a dog?
And she doesn't even have a dog.
She doesn't even have a dog.
It's kind of pathetic.
I mean, I know I don't have a dog either, but I have treats. I mean, who shows up at a party and doesn't bring something?
Before I got on Big Brother 6, 7, 14, 22, and The Amazing Race, I knew I would have to create a character, someone more interesting than my normal, everyday self. So I based my persona on my hero, Kim Lerner. Love you, Kim.
So how do you make an ending for a movie that's about a life that's only halfway over? I guess I could do that by just trying to explain why I made it. I couldn't plan a roller skating party like you wanted. Couldn't take you to Paris like I wanted. Pandemic kind of sucks. But what I could do is make a thing that I thought maybe would make you smile. Make you happy, and let you know how special you are. I hope I did that. I hope you know how lucky I feel to have been a part of 45 of those 50 years. Car, how lucky I feel to have ridden shotgun basically for 35 of those 50 years. And how happy I am to know that whatever comes next, whatever the ending is, I'm gonna be there with you. We're gonna be in there. We're gonna be in there. Dang, let's try that. We're gonna be in there. Our home, our happy place. I love you. Happy birthday. Next year in Paris on roller skates. Deal.
A 1, 2, 3, 4. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Kim. Happy birthday to you.
Whoop! Happy birthday. Happy 50th, Kim.
Happy 50th birthday.
Happy 50th. Happy birthday.
Happy 50th birthday, sweet Kim.
Hi, Kim.
Hi, Kim.
Happy 50th birthday.
Happy 50th birthday from the Olsteen
family.
So we've had a lot of fun times together, and here's to many more. Happy birthday. I hope it's a special one.
Happy birthday, sister. Happy, happy, happy 50th birthday. Hope you have a fantastic day. Love you lots.
Hey, Kim. Happy birthday from Lake Tahoe.
Happy birthday, Kim. I'm sorry that we can't celebrate you in person, but I hope you have a wonderful day.
Happy birthday, Kimberly.
Happy birthday, Nim.
Happy birthday, Mrs. Lerner.
Have a great my birthday.
Happy 50th birthday, Kim. I miss you. I hope you have a blast for your 50th birthday. I can't believe we're 50. I miss you. I think of you often. You take care. Bye-bye.
Happy 50th birthday, Kim, number two. I'll be right behind you. I never thought we'd get here. Officially old fart status. So many memories. We had a blast. Enjoy your special day with your family. Love you, Kim number one.
In all seriousness, Kim, happy birthday. I can't believe we're all turning 50. This is crazy. Where did the time go? Happy birthday.
Kim, it's been a long time. I really want to wish you the best. Happy birthday. When I think of you, I definitely think of some amazing memories, probably some of the best times in my life. You know, hanging out with you guys, you and your friends really made me laugh, and it definitely just smiled on my face of our childhood and how fortunate we were.
We lived, what, 10 houses away from each other or so. Horizon Elementary, Bear Middle School, Piper, Harvard, the amazing things we've done. Kidding. Don't worry about 50. 50's fine. If 50's a lot like 30, but with a little less hair and a lot more back pain. And I'm sure by now you got your AARP card, because that always comes on time. And wow, happy birthday, Kim. 50 years old. 50! 50!
So, Kim, I wish you the very best 50th birthday and many, many more years of happy birthdays.
Okay. So happy birthday,
happy
Kim.
Happy birthday,
Kim, and we wish you all good things in the coming years. And in the meantime, we love our ladies' lap, so keep on coming.
Happy birthday, Kimmy. We love you. Many more happy birthdays to come.
Happy birthday, Kim. I hope you have the best day and the best year yet. I miss you guys so much. I can't wait to see you. Love you. Hugs and kisses. Have a great day. Mwah.
Hey, Kim, hope you're doing awesome. Happy 50th from me and Melissa and all of our family. We love you. We miss you a ton.
Here's to 50 more.
50 more, and we wish you the happiest of birthdays, and we love
you.
Love
you, and we love you.
I know it's your birthday. There are very few birthdays that I know by heart. And yours just happens to be one of them. I guess it was that spiritual connection since we were 11 or 12 years old. So, wow, 11 or 12 has turned 50. No way, Kim, you're still as beautiful as you ever have been. And now it's time to stay beautiful. So welcome to the 50 Club. And I, even though I have no makeup on and I don't look my best right now, I'm gonna show you how I stay fit. This is a helpful way that a friend is sharing with you how she stays fit at 50. Come on, come on, girlfriend. Come on, Lulu, come on. Getting fit at 50 isn't easy. Happy birthday, girl, from your crazy friend from in Wellington. Come visit when COVID's over.
All kidding aside, Kimberly, we were made to say that stuff. We didn't mean any of it. And we're Maybe not wrong. Going to ruin this video by trying to sing. We are just going to tell you happy 50th birthday and how much we love you.
That was a good idea. And he spoke for me now.
That's the first time in 54 years.
Kim, happy 50th birthday. I am so sorry. I hope you found this funny. Garrett said you would find this funny. If you don't like this, blame Garrett, not me. Happy birthday. The story about the wedding part was true. It was one of the best weddings Ashley and I ever went to, except for the part where you threw people overboard and started hitting on the waitstaff. Happy 50th birthday.
I was guessing that you'd probably want me to come clean about what I do for a living. And, you know, all that vague travel and multiple passports and, you know, the sources of income that were very unclear. I just thought you'd be happy to know that I do work for... Hold on a second. Somebody's at the door. I'll be right back.
I can say it is truly an honor to wish my niece a happy, hard-to-believe 50th birthday. I have always considered Kimmy to be my guardian angel. She's always there to let me know when I have a booger hanging from my nose. She lets me know that I've got food stuck on my chin or I cut myself shaving and I'm bleeding. For all of those things, I appreciate her very, very much. But no, honestly, I can say, and say this without hesitation, Kimmy, you're annoying, you're a pest, but I still love you and wish you a happy, happy 50th birthday.
I want to wish you a very, very happy birthday. We love you. And I'm really glad that you guys live so close to us.
Hi, Kim. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Kim.
We were so thrilled that Garrett reached out to us to help with this mockumentary for your 50th birthday. Oh, my gosh.
Hey, two requests. One, continue to be happy and healthy and enjoy your years together with Garrett. And the second request is something from math teachers. You know, we're told often that, you know, who needs the stuff and no one's ever going to need it. And, you know, they'll never remember it, blah, 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 blah. So just to prove people wrong and to make my heart feel good, Kim, if you would just turn to somebody next to you, whoever you're watching this with, and share with them that you've remembered your math from high school. So tell them, go ahead, take your time, you know, take a full 30 seconds if you need to, and tell them what the tangent of pi over 2 is. I'll bet you can do it, because you are one of my favorites.
Go ahead, Kim, you can do it. You can do it.
Take care, happy birthday. Bye.
Bye.
What up, Kim? Hey, Kim, and happy 50th. This is a milestone. I am so excited for you. You are like fine wine. Old bitches are the baddest bitches. And I should know, I just turned 41. Yay! Happy birthday, Kim. I love you so, so much. And by the way, your husband's super hot. Love you, Kim. Oh, and I wanted to leave you with a couple sound bites, because it's your birthday. You're 50. Bye-bye, bitches.
Hi, Kim. Want to wish you a really big happy birthday. I've been traveling like crazy and working, so Denise told me no matter what to send you a happy birthday, even if it wasn't one of these really funny, crazy stories that everyone's submitting. So I just want to let you know that you're an incredible woman, and I'm so fortunate to know you between middle school, high school, and even my times that I traveled out to visit you and the family when I was working. I just can't wait for another 50. Love you.
Happy 50th birthday, Kim. I can't believe we're 50. And you get to go first. I know, counting the 12 days behind you, that I'll be right there. But in any case, I am just so excited to be able to send you a birthday message today and just reminisce on some of our wonderful memories that we've had the greatest fortune to have together. Having 42 years of friendship behind us is no small feat, and I am so blessed and happy that I got to share so many of the best times with you. So let's start with my very little short. I know I can't take up too much time, but our little short memory lane. Because when I thought about doing what I was going to do, I said, what reminds me of Kim? And this popped into my head. Yes, little cute cuddly koalas. When I think of Kim, I think of her little love for the little cuddly koala. And how cool these were when we were in sixth grade and we'd clip them onto our little unicorn backpacks. The best. I think of you every time I see one. And then the next one, of course, we can never forget our little twinsies to our field trip in middle school. And we went shopping at the county seat for our OP shirts and our dolphin shorts, because we looked so much alike. Yay, twins. And then when I was talking to Garrett, I was remembering how after your dad did your room all cool with the window seat and the bookshelves, and we would sit on your carpet and play probably the tape recorder and rewind it so that we can get all the lyrics to the latest Chicago song on the radio. So every time I hear them, I think of you. And of course, the hours and hours and hours of coming up with our little characters, which they're as old as we are, pretty much. So those are just a little fun couple of things that I think of when I think of you, alongside a million, million memories of being at your house and having family dinners and eating pizza bagels and annoying you as I bit the fork eating the corn. And watching Grease like over and over and over and over again. Just really great times. And growing up together is just one of my greatest fondest memories to be able to do it with you and Dominique and Kim and so many of our good friends that we're still friends with. So it's amazing. I love every minute of that. So I just want to wish you the happiest of birthdays today and always. And I look forward to a time when we can actually celebrate in person. Who knows, after this is over, I might just get on a plane and come see you. So enjoy your special, special day. I love you so, so much. And my life wouldn't be the same without you, because you've been such a big part of it. So happy 50th birthday. I love you.
Now here we are, 50 years later. Wow. My little girl. Daughter. Sister. Doctor. Wife. Awesome mother of two. Strong. Loving. Beautiful woman. I thank God every day for the gift that he gave me, you, and for allowing me to be part of your life's journey. Watch all your dreams come true. From my heart to yours. Happy birthday, Kimmy girl. I love you. Boy, she better appreciate this. It took me longer than giving birth.
But I just wanted to let you know that love you. You take care of me.